his view. This real transition.
All right, so we got our box from Amazon. I bought the kit from ProFlow Aerobic Systems. If y'all want to see that or not, but the kit was about $75. It's always important to use the sharpest scalpel that you possibly have to open packages with. That way, when you cut yourself, you don't only cut your finger, you cut yourself all the way to the bone. So, that's our kit that we got. Invoice. Yeah, look at that part. I don't think you can see that, bud. $81. So, what it comes with. New air filter. Do not throw away. Blue and clear plastic bags. Container parts needed for repairs. When in doubt, don't ever read the instructions. We got cylinder head, or seals. That's our cylinder heads, blue parts. Should be everything we need. And cut these guys open. That one open. So, take our cover off. And wonder what happened to my Ziploc bag that had all the parts in. We'll be right back. Alright, I found my bag. All my parts that I had. Open it up. That's the. That's the old air filter, jump parts, the old diaphragms, head. That's all. So I went and got my socket. It's a 7mm using a little 1/4 inch. That's a one of my other videos you guys will see about my service truck. I told you that I've got a 3/8 snap-on ratchet like this. One of my favorite ratchets, these swivel heads. These work really good, and one of the reasons because if you're at a 90 degree, let's see if you can see that. If you're at a 90 degree like that, that's what most ratchets work at. Well, if you can't really get on it at a 90 degree, like say you can only get an angle like that, or way up there, you get offset a bit. But the number one thing I like is once you get it loose enough, you can spin it straight like that, and then you can just spin it out by hand. Now this piece, they call this the bar assembly. You pull that bar out, that one pulled out, but you can pull it all the way out. What this is your magnets on each side. You need to make sure this thing getting cracked. Sometimes if it gets really hot, it'll get real cracked. Now this one, I don't know if you can tell or not, it actually has little bitty cracks in the magnet. Now we're not worried about that. Most magnets, these iron ferrite magnets are, you know, real, real brittle anyway, so. Stick this guy back in.
let's put it on YouTube.
Phone's not doing anything right now. It's just showing me what the GoPro is singing. Perpetually. Alright, so go put the other head on. You've got this little area up here. You can see a little notch on this side, so that's how you know your orientation. Oh, you know what? I forgot to get ahead of myself. Gotta put the washer and the nut on.
Hi guys! And nope, those tools are mine, right Dad?
Yep.
Have you used this one yet?
Yep.
Have you used all of them?
No, I haven't used that big one.
Yeah, this shocked me, Dad. Did you know that?
Nope.
You didn't know what shocked me?
I didn't know that it shocked you.
What happens if you put one of these wires together?
Nothing.
Can I try?
Alright, so something on these nuts, if you can tell that's on the camera or not, it's got a little rounded area on top. I don't know if it's going to focus or not. Why are you focusing? Yeah, let's focus on everything in the background. So anyway, you can kind of see that. That rounded area on top has a little lock washer in the very edge. So you need to make sure that when you put this back together.
Oh, you should have made.
Zoom in or anything. It's not a macro lens, but you see this little piece up here. Alright, so this is a plastic screw. And it's a little bitty nut. So what this does, it goes through. Through both of these pieces like this. All the way through that side. Okay, and you put that little plastic nut on it. You want to make really, really sure that you do not over tighten this. If you do, you'll be buying a whole nother kit. They won't sell you just this plastic screw. I guess they make too much money on the,
Alright. Oh,
almost bit the dirt. So that's it for inside. Make sure that guy's on there. So we put this back on top. This is the brand new filter that goes up here. It's under like that. So while I'm putting this cover back on, I guess I'll ask about something else. I had a subscriber ask me about if I was going to make a Patreon account. And I replied to him and said, I don't know if I'm going to make a Patreon account or not. Part of me kind of feels like it's basically begging for money. And the other part of me, you know, doesn't feel that way. It feels like, well, I mean, people, you know, I contribute to other people's Patreons. Like, I contribute to AVE, or have. I don't do it on a monthly basis. But I don't know. I don't know if I'm going to or not. As far as this channel is concerned, I would like to have people send me tools and products and stuff to review. But I don't know, you know, I don't want to get into someone sends me a product that I'm not really impressed with, or, you know, like if somebody sends me a cans of spray paint. I don't want to review cans of spray paint. It's not what I'm about. I mean, it has, you know, it's not part of the deal. But if somebody did send me a you know, set of wrenches or something, well, yeah, I'd gladly put it, make a video, an honest video about, you know, what I, how I feel the wrenches are. So I guess Patreon accounts allow you to do that. You know, to where you're not relying on the money of companies sending you stuff. So I don't know. I guess you guys put it in the comments below. See what y'all feel like. If, you know, y'all think a Patreon account is a good idea, or do you think it's kind of begging for money? Eventually, I would like to make enough money off of YouTube to where I could not have to go, you know, work 50, 60 hours a week like I'm doing now, and I'd be able to work around the homestead, the ranch, and show videos of that. You know, mechanic repair, you know, kind of take, you know, a few side jobs to give, still give me something to do, but mainly, you know, to make videos off of. Something I would eventually like to do, and this would be my, I would think it'd be an awesome deal, if I could make enough off of YouTube eventually to where I could buy a piece of equipment that needs a lot of work, you know, like an older Caterpillar excavator or a skid steer or just something, and then like completely just rebuild it. I mean, tear everything down, make videos about tearing everything down, put it all back together and sell it after I'm done with it to a, you know, subscriber or something, or donate it to charity, or I don't know. You know, I'm not real concerned about the money from it. I'm just I don't make enough money right now to you know, go out and buy a $10,000-$20,000 piece of equipment and then put a, you know, $6,000 worth of parts in the engine, another $3,000 of parts in the pump and all that, you know. But if I was making enough money off YouTube as far as the Patreon account and the YouTube monies, then I would. But I mean, that's years down the road. But anyway, yeah, let me know what you guys think. That'd be something I should look into or not. Well, it's night time right now, so I can't go out and put this air pump on. And when I do put this air pump on, I need to actually flush out the this part where it hooks up, because there's a piece of PVC pipe that goes into the tank and down, and then spreads back out like that. It's got little holes in it. Well, the problem in septic tanks is if you have an aeration or an aerobic setup and you got an air pump, and it sits for any length of time, the solids end up covering that pipe. So if you hook your brand new air pump up to your pipe and it's covered, this thing just sits there and it doesn't actually move any air. Those cylinder heads in there, the little diaphragms just go back and forth. And because there's no fresh air coming in, everything overheats, and then we're right back to square one having to replace these air diaphragms. And otherwise, the other side or other part of that is if some of the holes are blocked, some aren't, this thing's going to work overtime and working too hard, so it's going to end up messing up again. So I want to make sure that I flush some air through those holes and have it get out of there. Ah, hey. cat's getting in the trash. Anyway, you gotta make sure all those holes are cleared up, and there's really no good way to do that unless you, A, have your tanks completely sucked out by a septic truck, and then visually, you know, inspect it, which is a pretty nasty job. Or the other aspect is what most plumbers do. Instead of even jacking with that, they just run a whole new pipe down in there, then hook this pump up to it. And I might do that, I might not. It just depends on when we get out there. But when we get out there, I'll take the cover off. And then luckily YouTube doesn't have smell-o-vision yet, so you guys won't have to be subjected to that. But I can look down in there and see if that pipe is all clogged. Anyway, next video will be installing this. So I guess I'm a little mistaken on this. I guess there's a tank separation here to this one. So you can tell this is the solids tank is over there. This is the clarifying tank. So when I hook air to this side, to watch it over here, you'll see it start bubbling up. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to sit here, let this thing run for a while and try to blow out that pipe instead of replacing that pipe. It should be good to go. Tube clamp on this guy to, or screw clamp, because I really don't like these spring clamps on anything. I know this deal just, it doesn't even put out that much air, but it'll be good for testing. And so now I need to run my cords here, get my GoPro to wake up.
That's what I saw, Dad.
There it goes. So I need to get my cord routed through here, open up my box, and then stick that end through there, and then make my electrical connections.
Yeah, that's what it was like with me, too.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, the GoPro.
Moment of truth.
Dad, I feel something on the roof.
Yep. That's a spot. Y'all can hear that or not, but that pump is going, but I still have a yellow light on because there's that little tube on the bottom of this pump that's not hooked up, but I think that'll work. So I'll go ahead and shut this box. Probably not gonna go get the Got a little piece of tube today because I got some at work.
And I hunted the buck down for
you. All right. So I wonder.
Got a. I forgot to run the pump. So the alarm works.
What does that beep 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 mean?
So this alarm works, but this buzzer is really, really quiet. Should be loud like that. But for some reason, this isn't turning my pump on. So when you turn this, you push that up and run, that pump should come on. I'm gonna shut it off for now. So I get that piece of hose, but start the video back up. All right, so got some rubber hose that I think is for windshield washers. Got it at work, piece of scrap, so put it on a little barb there. That's where you put it. Oh. Alright, so it won't fit. So I'm going to try to make a little shim out of a paint sample. All I got here is a kid's glue stick. Don't really need it to be real sticky. I just need it to stick long enough to jam in the hole. So we'll try. That's it for the septic tank repair. The only other thing I got to fix on it is when I was on this pump, when I flipped that up, that should manually make that pump come on and start pumping out there in the yard, but it doesn't. So anyway, I'll go get my screwdriver real quick. I'm gonna take this off, take the leads from that switch and touch them together, see if I can get the pump to come on. Yeah.